For the first half of Southwestern Seminary's 94 years, the Founders' Day address was focused on the life, ministry, and work of Benaja Harvey Carroll, its founder. Founders' Day in this institution has been properly spelled F-O-U-N-D-E-R-apostrophe-S because indeed it had a single founder. Not until 1954 does the record show a Founders' Day address on another person, the life of Southwestern's second president, Lee R. Scarborough. From that time forward, subjects of the address for this special day have been diverse. On other presidents, namely E.D. Head and J. Howard Williams, on early professors, Connor, Ray, Reynolds, Price, Barnes, Newman, Dana, C.B. Williams, on schools like education and music, on departments, preaching, missions, pastoral ministry, on the roles of George Truett and Frank Norris, on the relationship of Southwestern to the Baptist denomination, on the very nature of Southwestern itself, and sometimes again, on B.H. Carroll. I propose today to undertake something different, namely an interpretive review of the published writings in book form by Southwestern professors that have helped to shape the Southwestern tradition or ethos. Southwestern has had its presidents, its trustees, its buildings, its donors, its endowment, its student bodies, its alumni scattered throughout the world, each of which has significance. Today, I invite your attention to those professors whose considerable literary production has been foundational to the process of learning and maturing for ministry that has been going on for more than 9 decades in the Southwestern context. Southwestern's first dean and professor of church history, Albert Henry Newman, was the most published member of the original faculty. Prior to his association with Baylor Theological Seminary, the predecessor of Southwestern, he had written a history of the Baptist churches in the United States for the series American Church History, had co-translated and co-edited the anti-Manichaean writings of Augustine of Hippo for the Nicene and post-Nicene fathers, and had authored a history of anti-pedobaptism from the rise of pedobaptism to AD 1609, a notable study of pre-Reformation reform movements. As he was joining the faculty of Baylor, Newman produced a 2-volume manual of church history, which was highly theological, reflected his pre-Reformation and Reformation expertise, and was used as a text at Southwestern at least to the latter 1950s. The books authored by B.H. Carroll were more numerous after his death than during his lifetime. Only a few of his sermons and doctrinal booklets were issued in book form before his death in 1914. The publication by Fleming Ravel Company and by the Sunday School Board of Carroll's 13-volume, later to become 17, An Interpretation of the English Bible, reflecting his teaching of the entire English Bible in the New Southwestern Seminary, under the editorship of J.B. Cranfill and J.W. Crowder, began in 1913 and was completed in 1917. But with 5 volumes on the Old Testament, later 9, and 8 on the New Testament, Carroll was one of the few Baptists since the 18th century John Gill to publish singly a commentary on the whole Bible. Broadwind Press reprinted this set in 1942-43 and again in 47-48, and Baker Bookhouse did so in 1976. Between 1928 and 1952, Crowder and Cranfill collaborated to bring into print 15 volumes of Carroll's sermons, predominantly doctrinal sermons, usually arranged in volumes thematically. Calvin Goodspeed, first professor of systematic theology, had written a treatise in which he defended immersion in believers' baptism, a monograph on eschatology, espousing postmillennialism, and a commentary on Genesis, in which day in Genesis 1 was taken to denote a period of indefinite duration. The second dean of Southwestern, Charles B. Williams, was the first professor of New Testament and Greek. After his tenure at Southwestern, produced a translation of the New Testament in 1937. The New Testament, a translation in the language of the people, marked by the use of everyday words and the nearest cultural equivalents. L.R. Scarborough, the first professor of evangelism, helped to create the 20th century literature on Christian evangelism with 5 books on the subject. With Christ After the Loss, 1919, considered by Scarborough as his most important writing, focused on personal evangelism and was used as a textbook at Southwestern and other seminaries. Then followed, Endued to Win, Christ's Militant Kingdom, A Search for Souls, and How Jesus Won Men. Scarborough produced 4 books of sermons, histories of the 75 million campaign and of Southwestern Seminary, and 3 volumes on vocational Christian ministry and the Christian life. But Williams's successor in the New Testament field, Harvey Eugene Dana, would prove to be much more prolific. Indeed, the author of about 30 book titles that covered almost every aspect of New Testament study. Historical background, criticism, canon, grammar, hermeneutics, exposition, apologetics, and theology. Dana's intermediate level New Testament Greek grammar, co-authored with Julius Manti, first appeared in 1923 and is still in use today. His The New Testament World in 3 editions focused on the historical, political, social, moral, and religious background of the New Testament. Dana's book on biblical hermeneutics was the first book on biblical hermeneutics by a Southern Baptist. And likewise, Dana's The Ephesian Tradition, which found 3 strata of tradition in the Gospel of John, Palestinian, Pauline, and Ephesian, marked the pioneering application of form criticism to the Gospel of John. And Dana's book on ecclesiology, second edition being co-authored by L.M. Sipes, placed Dana among the 3 D's of Southern Baptist ecclesiology, Dag, Dargan, and Dana. Dana's successor in New Testament, Ray Summers, would also produce the New Testament Greek grammar, widely used on the elementary level, but would be better known for his contributions to the interpretation of the New Testament apocalypse and to the exposition of amillennial eschatology. His commentary on Revelation, Worthy is the Lamb, espoused a historical background method of interpretation, which actually combined the preterist method with the philosophy of history method. And his Life Beyond summarized New Testament doctrine of last things on the basis of an amillennial rendering of Revelation 21-7, so that Summers advocated the imminence of the second coming of Christ in a manner not possible for the postmillennialist, the historic premillennialist, or the dispensationalist. More recent New Testament professors at Southwestern have followed in the Dana Summers tradition by authoring grammars of the Greek New Testament. Lacoste Munn and Bruce Corley, Curtis Vaughn and Virtus Gideon, Hubert Drumright, James Brooks, Lauren Cranford. Moreover, J.W. McGorman produced a monograph on spiritual gifts and commentaries on 4 New Testament books, and Drumright monographs about prayer and about lesser known persons in the New Testament. Vaughn published commentaries on 14 books of the New Testament and edited the remarkably useful The New Testament from 26 translations. And the total number of copies of Vaughn's book in English and in numerous translations has exceeded 1.25 million copies. Thomas Lee, in addition to authoring 2 commentaries with Vaughn, wrote an introduction to the New Testament, the volume on pastoral epistles in the New American Commentary, and 2 books on how to study the Bible. Brooks produced a major commentary on Mark and a monograph in New Testament textual criticism, and Corley edited Colloquy on New Testament Studies. Earl Ellis, after various earlier books on Pauline studies, Lucan studies, and the relation of the 2 Testaments, authored at the end of the 20th century a magisterial trilogy, all published by Brill. First, The Making of the New Testament Documents, in which, countering or overturning F.C. Bauer, he posited that the writings of the New Testament originated from 1 of 4 apostolic missions, Jacobean, Petrine, Pauline, Johannine. And then secondly, Christ in the Future in New Testament History, and finally, History and Interpretation in New Testament Perspective. Scholarly publications in the Old Testament increased in the latter part of the 20th century. Ralph Lee Smith, after a lifetime of teaching the subject of Old Testament theology, authored in 1993 a major book in the field. as well as having written on Amos in the Broadman Commentary and the Micah through Malachi volume in the Word Biblical Commentary. F.B. Huey produced commentaries on Exodus, Numbers, Ruth, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Esther, and monographs on the Old Testament prophets and on obedience to God, the latter being a theme that runs throughout Huey's writings. Commentaries on Joshua, Judges, and Ruth and Lamentations were written by Dan Kent. Three professors, Bruce Corley, Steve Lemke, and Grant Lovejoy, collaborated to co-edit a comprehensive textbook on biblical hermeneutics, and Thomas Briscoe produced an award-winning biblical atlas. Southwestern's church historians have so engaged in writing as to form a historiographical succession. W.W. Barnes wrote two books on the Southern Baptist Convention. The first, a small volume in 1934, which is prophetic of the centralization, or as Barnes put it, presbygationalism that has occurred in the SBC. And the second, the authorized 19-chapter centennial history of the SBC, finally published in 1954, focused on the convention itself and greatly utilizing primary sources. Barnes's younger colleague, Robert A. Baker, proved to be more prolific. Baker addressed an issue that was lively in the 1940s, the history of the relations between Northern and Southern Baptists. Baker not only produced summaries of general church history, of Baptist history, and of Baptist beginnings in the South, but also excelled as a Baptist institutional historian with monographs on the histories of the Sunday School Board, the Annuity Board, Texas Baptist, Southwestern Seminary, and Southern Baptists. The last named volume, entitled The Southern Baptist Convention and Its People, 1607 to 1972, took the story back to the Charleston beginnings. Baker's younger colleague, William R. Estep, contributed to Anabaptist scholarship by means of his much translated Anabaptist story and Anabaptist Beginnings, a source book, to Reformation studies by Renaissance and Reformation, and by editing the Luther Anabaptist volume in Christian Classics, to ecumenical studies with his Baptist and Christian Unity, to religious liberty by two volumes, and to Baptist studies by his sesquicentennial history of the Foreign Mission Board and his Why Baptists. Leon Macbeth was the author of monographs on great male missionaries and on women in Baptist history, and a book on American religious cults before producing his magnum opus in 1987, The Baptist Heritage, an 850-page history of Baptists in Europe and North America, which has become the standard in its field. More recently, Macbeth completed a comprehensive history of Texas Baptists. Thomas Nels co-authored with Russ Bush, Baptists in the Bible, a volume significant for recent Southern Baptist controversy, and wrote By His Grace and For His Glory, a historic study of the Dortian Calvinistic dimension in Baptist life. Justice Anderson authored in Spanish the three-volume Historia de los Bautistas, the third volume of which constitutes the most complete history of Baptists in Asia, Africa, and Latin America, and which awaits needed translation into English. Both Baker and Macbeth edited source books of Baptist history. Southwestern professors have also written at least 11 histories of local Baptist congregations: Baker, Estep, Macbeth, Nettles, Robert Coleman, and Karen Bullock. Southwestern's writings in theology for nearly half a century were predominantly the output of Walter Thomas Connor. His one-volume System of Christian Doctrine, 1924, replaced Mullins's book as the systematic theology textbook at Southwestern. He condensed for college classes this under the title Christian Doctrine in 1937. His revision of the first half of System was issued as Revelation in God in 1936, and the second half as the Gospel of Redemption in 1945. Connor produced a general survey of New Testament theology and monographs on the resurrection of Jesus, sainthood, the Holy Spirit, and the atonement. Connor saw no conflict between the authority of Christ and the authority of the Bible, but held that commitment to a particular theory of the inspiration of the Bible or a particular theory of the imputation of original sin was not necessary. Connor shifted from penal substitution to Christ as victor, from postmillennialism to amillennialism. A treatment of Connor's life and theology was authored by Stuart Newman. Boyd Hunt was the author of Redeemed, Eschatological Redemption and the Kingdom of God, in which he magnified both present and future aspects of the Kingdom of God. Books on a theology for children and a theology for aging came from the pen of William L. Hendricks, who also authored monographs on the doctrines of man and Christology and on the epistles of John. Russell Dilday wrote The Doctrine of Biblical Authority, Bert Dominey, God's Work of Salvation. John Kiewit authored books on the Anabaptist leader Pilgrim Marpeck and on the contemporary Roman Catholic theologian Hans Küng. And Jeff Poole edited a volume about the 1963 Baptist Faith and Message Statement and wrote a monograph on Southern Baptist Creedalism. Millard Erickson, after early books on the new evangelical theology, on ethical relativism and on various millennial and tribulational views, and a three-volume anthology for systematic theology, produced during 1983 to 85 his three-volume, later published as one, Christian Theology, which has had wide usage in evangelical institutions and which has been both condensed and revised. Recently, Erickson has written monographs that sought to interpret or reinterpret classical theological issues such as Christology, the Trinity, and the attributes of God, and books dealing specifically with contemporary evangelicalism, with the future of theology, and with the destiny of the unevangelized. Southwestern's pioneer in Christian ethics, T.B. Maston, was a prolific author, writing as many books after retirement as before. His most comprehensive textbooks were Biblical Ethics, 1967, and Why Live the Christian Life, 1974. Before and during the Civil Rights Movement, Maston wrote courageously on racial issues in Of One, The Bible and Race, and Segregation and Desegregation. World and Social Ethical Issues were the subject of three titles, and similarly, Maston produced three books concerning moral decision-making, Right or Wrong, God's Will in Your Life, The Conscience of a Christian. He also wrote on family life, on the religious liberty advocacy of Isaac Bacchus, on suffering, and on the personal Christian walk. William Pinson, also a prolific author, wrote four books on contemporary social issues, three on family life, three related to youth, four on pastoral ministry, one on Maston's life and thought, and one on Baptist identity. Guy Greenfield has authored six volumes, most of which deal with family life. John P. Newport, a teacher scholar with a wide range of interests, developed the philosophy of religion, Christian apologetics area expansively. His interest in the arts led him to theology and contemporary art forms. His interest in religious cults produced Demons, 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 Christ and the New Consciousness, and his last book, The New Age Movement and the Biblical Worldview. Newport's early training in New Testament studies is reflected in his co-authored Why Christians Fight Over the Bible and his commentary on Revelation, The Lion and the Lamb, in which he espoused a historic premillennial interpretation. Philosophical interests surface in his book on Paul Tillich and theological in What is Christian Doctrine. But Newport's magnum opus was Life's Ultimate Questions, a 12-chapter comprehensive textbook on philosophy of religion from the starting point of a biblical worldview. Newport's younger colleague Yandel Woodfin had previously published a textbook entitled With All Your Mind and also wrote Why Be a Christian. Three Southwestern professors of preaching, H.C. Brown, Gordon Kleinert, and Jesse Northcutt, all co-authored Steps to the Sermon in 1963, a textbook featuring eight steps that provides for the beginning preacher a basic understanding of the nature and task of preaching and instructs him about sermon preparation and delivery. Widely used and revised in 1996 by Al Faisal, it is still in print. Brown himself authored a seminal contribution to homiletical literature, A Quest for Reformation in Preaching, in which in unparalleled fashion he set forth a detailed method for measuring the relationship of the sermon to its biblical text. Brown edited five books of sermons, wrote three others on preaching and teaching, edited a two-volume work on contemporary ethical issues, and produced two books in his own struggle with sorrow and illness. Clyde Fant and William Pinson collaborated in editing a monumental 13-volume reprint series of Christian sermons for 20 centuries, the majority of which were taken from the modern era. Al Faisal has written monographs on sermon delivery and sermon preparation, a biographically oriented history of Baptist preaching in the southern United States, and has edited a volume of sermon classics. Southern Baptist Preaching Today and Southern Baptist Preaching Yesterday were co-edited by Joel Gregory, who has also written Too Great a Temptation, The Seductive Power of America's Super Church. Calvin Miller is probably Southwestern's most prolific author with at least 50 titles. Perhaps best known for the Singer Trilogy, billed in its subtitle as the mythic retelling of the story of the New Testament, Miller also produced two other trilogies, the Singreal Chronicles and the Symphony Trilogy. Miller has written 11 volumes on the Christian life or Christian spirituality, 6 on preaching and pastoralia, 4 of poetry for children, 4 more of fiction, 3 of devotions, 2 on marriage, 2 of sermons. Miller also edited an anthology of excerpts on various aspects of the life of Jesus from numerous Christian authors. Southwestern's first full-time professor of evangelism, C.E. Autry, was the author of 6 books, 1 a basic textbook, 2 on biblical revivals, 1 on the theology of evangelism, 1 on methods, and 1 of sermons. Malcolm McDowell has co-authored an important history of revivals that stretches from Mount Sinai to the 1990s. Dan Crawford has issued 2 books on prayer, 2 on revival preparation, 2 on evangelism, 1 on church growth, and 1 on spiritual formation, and co-authored an account of the Wedgwood Baptist Church shootings. Kenneth Hemphill, after an initial book concerning spiritual gifts according to Paul, has written 3 books on the Sunday school, 3 on church growth, and monographs on evangelism, the Christian life, the names of God, and the Lord's Prayer. Frank Means wrote 4 volumes on foreign missions, 1 of which focused on Latin America, and Courts Redford wrote 3 books on Southern Baptist home missions. In 1998, Justice Anderson and Ebby Smith were co-editors of a 750-page textbook on missiology for Southern Baptist seminaries. Smith had written 3 monographs related to church growth, 2 of a general nature, and 1 focused on Indonesia. Daniel Sanchez wrote Sharing Our Faith with Roman Catholic Friends and in Spanish, monographs on contextualization and on the doctrine of last things. Samuel Shahid is the author of 45 books and booklets, 41 in Arabic and 4 in English, including short stories and novels and literary critical studies. And Shahid has translated the entire Old Testament into modern Arabic. Franklin Sigler produced 2 major volumes in pastoral ministry, Theology of Church and Ministry, 1960, and Christian Worship, Its Theology and Practice, 1967, the latter being revised by Randall Bradley in 1996. Moreover, Sigler also wrote on the Christian laity, 2 inspirational books, The Broadman Minister's Manual, a book on aging, and an autobiography. C.W. Brister, early in his teaching at Southwestern, authored a text in the field entitled Pastoral Care in the Church, 1964, published by Harper and Row. Rejecting the restriction of pastoral care to the ordained ministers or clergy, Brister addressed the pastoral role of the entire congregation without compromising the essential role of ordained leadership. Widely used in many seminaries, it was twice revised and remained in print for 29 years. Brister wrote 3 other volumes on caregiving and books on doubt, on adolescence, on stress in marriage, on counseling, on beginning one's ministry, and on change. Southwestern's pioneer and curriculum builder in religious education, John Milburn Price, began his writing by addressing social problems, collaborated on 3 books dealing with religious education in general, wrote a widely circulated and translated book entitled Jesus the Teacher, authored 3 volumes on character building and life's problems, issued a study of life stages, and edited 3 volumes of a biographical nature. Price's younger colleague, William L. House, authored 4 books pertaining to the Sunday school, 1 on the church staff, and 2 on the structure and functioning of the congregation. Donald Bell wrote 4 books on Christian applied psychology. William R. Yount produced a major textbook on educational psychology, and Lucian Coleman, 3 books on how to interpret the Bible and why and how to teach. Leroy Ford authored 10 books designed to foster diversity of method in church teaching and training. Charles Tidwell, 3 books on church administration. And N.R. Drummond, Tidwell, Yount, and Daryl Eldridge each wrote or edited substantive introductions to the entire teaching ministry of the church. John William Drakeford is another prolific writer, having authored or co-authored 33 books. 11 of these have dealt with aspects of marriage and family life, whereas 4 have pertained to sexual deviations, and 4 have belonged to Drakeford's Awesome Power series. 2 books have pertained to therapy, 2 to counseling, and 2 to John Wesley. His longest book was Psychology in Search of the Soul, 1964. Richard Ross, before joining Southwestern's faculty, had authored, co-authored, edited, or co-edited 14 books concerning ministry to youth. The literary output of Southwestern's music professors does not, of course, encompass the music which they have composed, but has covered a wide range of subjects. I.E. Reynolds, the first faculty member, wrote music and the scriptures. 2 professors wrote histories of church music, David Appleby in 1965 and Robert Douglas in 1967. T.W. Jack Dean authored a history of Protestant church music in 20th century America. With respect to Christian hymnody, William J. Reynolds first issued in 1963 a survey of Christian hymnody, which has now had 4 editions, and in 1964 a companion to the 1956 Baptist hymnal. Then Reynolds, having edited the 1975 Baptist hymnal, produced the companion to that Baptist hymnal. Reynolds, David Music, and Scotty Gray co-authored in 1992 a handbook for the 1991 Baptist hymnal. Music and 2 others co-authored a monograph on Baptist hymnody in America. W.J. Reynolds again demonstrated his storytelling skill as to hymns in Songs of Glory, 1990, and Music edited a volume of hymnological source readings and produced a bibliography on 20th century British and American hymnody. Concerning the ministry of music, I.E. Reynolds authored 3 books. In the area of theory, James McKinney authored 4 books on reading music. Congregational singing was the subject of a book co-authored by B.B. McKinney and of a book authored by W.J. Reynolds. James McKinney issued a manual on singing and a major monograph on vocal faults. T.W. Hunt wrote on music and missions, whereas Hunt's later writings pertain to prayer and spirituality. The English language books by Southwestern professors have been translated into 6 European languages: Spanish, Portuguese, German, Italian, Czech, and Serbo-Croatian. 4 Oriental languages: Chinese, Korean, Indonesian, and Japanese. And 1 Middle Eastern language, Arabic, and also into Braille. It should now be evident that members of the Southwestern faculty have produced a considerable collection of books on a vast array of subjects, books which have been utilized both within Southwestern by professors and students and elsewhere has its global dimensions. Let those who would become the Southwestern of the 21st century be mindful of those who have written and what they have written. And let them strive by the grace of God through the ministry of writing to parallel and to exceed these labors of yesteryear.